Okay guys, now let's do a drill on letter writing this time. Let's first have a copy of this handout.
Okay?
Okay guys, now let's first go over the first 8 items here, and let's aim guys to correct the items at the bottom, and I have to rewrite the whole letter, okay, because there are some mistakes here or errors at the bottom. Let's first take a look at numbers 1 to 8 at the top, okay? So complete this advice on writing letters by circling the best options in italics. So for example, number 1, you must or you shouldn't include an address. Must you or shouldn't include an address? Okay, now normally guys, we write letters, we write addresses. However, in the IELTS test, you don't have the right address. In fact, clearly, at the very beginning of the task, that you are specifically told not to write any addresses. So when you write good letters, therefore, what's the very first line that you write? The salutation, the dear sir or madam part, or the dear blank part, okay? Therefore, the answer for number 1 is shouldn't. That's number 1. Okay, how about number 2? You can write under or just over 150 words.
Just over.
What happens if you write under 150 words? It becomes, yeah, exactly, you get penalized for underwriting. If your work is underworded, hindi umabot ng 150 words, there's a penalty. Now, there's this one criterion, guys, in Task 1 writing, the so-called task achievement, together with the other 3, there's the so-called coherence and cohesion. There is the so-called lexical resource. At the same time, grammatical range and accuracy. Now, you can recall, I talked about the criteria in speaking about 3 days or 4 days ago on Monday, and if you notice, it is in these two areas in which makapareho si speaking at saka si writing. Lexical resource, as you remember, is what? Lexical resource is basically your vocabulary, your words. And grammatical range and accuracy means our grammar, right? Task achievement, guys, dito kayo magka-penalize. Because you are graded between 1 and 9. So, for example, okay yung letter, kaya lang, underworded, from 7, magiging 6 na lang siya in this particular area. So therefore, if initially the examiner rates this part as a 7, it gets a minus 1. If it's between 140 and 149 words only, okay? So therefore, be very careful because dito kayo nakapenalize, not on total. It would not be fair if you are penalized against the total, only allowed for the task achievement criteria. That's why, guys, you have to write over 150 words. Now, question, do you include the dear, sir, madam, and the yours truly part in the counting? Actually, no, it's not included. Therefore, the 150 words means the body only of the letter. From the Rabi Bala group. No, it's not. Okay? Because it's part of the letter. It's part of the letter. The dear part. So that means to say less 3 or 4 words at the end. Dear sir or madam. Tapos meron ka pang yours sincerely. Plus if you have 3 words for your name, that's minus 10 words. So you have to at least 10 extra words to cover for the body of your letter. Okay? Yes.
Are we penalized also our letter will go over to $100.
There are no penalties if you go more than 200.
Much better.
Because there are no upper limits as regards the maximum number of words. The only risk, though, is that if you write too long, you risk committing many mistakes. Therefore, the more mistakes, or the longer the text, the riskier it becomes. Hence, while it's a good idea to write long, provided that you do not commit mistakes, okay, it's okay. Right? So, no upper limits, just the minimum. So, no penalties for that. Okay? All right. Number three. It is acceptable or unacceptable to begin, "Dear Mr. Manager."
Unacceptable.
Why do you say it's unacceptable?
It's quite easier if you don't know the person. Don't address him as Mr. Manager. Just you are saying, you will say,
"Dear Sir, or Madam." Correct. That's absolutely correct. The same goes also, guys, especially if you're writing to your boss. You cannot write "Dear Boss" or "Dear Mr. Supervisor," for example. No. There are also, guys, situations and letters in which it is likely that you do not know the addressee. So, for example, if you are writing to a bank manager because you lost your credit card and you have to report the card, would you know who the bank manager is? You would not in real life situations. Therefore, how would you start your letter? If that's the case. How do we start? Namir. Sorry. Are you with me? Okay, if you are writing for someone you don't know, what's the appropriate way of starting the letter? Correct. And normally, guys, the letter provides how you start. Okay. So if the letter text tells you, "Begin your letter as Dear Sir or Madam," what that means, guys, is that you really have to use "Sir or Madam." It isn't a choice between "Sir or Madam." It should be both, because you don't know really for sure whether you are addressing a man or a woman. Therefore, yes, we should do this. But what if you are writing to your, say, landlord? You have some problems with your unit, your rental space. Do you write "Dear Mr. Landlord"? How would you do it, Jose?
"Dear Mr. Name."
Mr. plus the name. Good. So guys, compare this one hand. When we have a letter that's supposed to be written to someone that we're supposed to know, in that case, we have to invent a name. Normally, guys, if that's the task, the letter drill will only ask that you complete the blank space, which means you are free to create a name because the situation calls for it. That you should know who the address is. So if that were the reason, guys, you instead write "Dear, say Mr. Smith." And correspondingly, how would you end your letter? In our, at the bottom of our letter, guys, how do we end?
Respectfully yours.
Okay, guys. "You respectfully yours," let's not use that in our letters, okay? Because when we are writing to someone whom we do not know, the best way to end is to use "yours faithfully." But then you can learn your address. Okay. If you know that, guys, then you write "sincerely only." You can also use the word "true," "yours truly" or "yours sincerely." Now, take note, please take a look at the capitalization. Only the "y" is in big letters. The "f" is small. as well as the S together. Okay? Now, if you want to reverse the order, you would want to write faithfully yours, that's also correct. But always, guys, all the first letter is capitalized. Okay? Truly yours, sincerely yours, also correct. Now, do we end the letter with our first name only in this case? It should be our complete name. Guys, why? Because both the sentence letters are formal. Okay? So in this case, we write, say, Juan de la Cruz. The same goes also at the bottom part. Juan de la Cruz. So guys, I just limit your expressions to these ones over here. Okay? So to answer therefore number three, no, it is not acceptable. Right? Number four. You should or don't need to check your grammar and spelling.
Should.
You should. From the criteria I wrote earlier, grammar is definitely important. Therefore, we should check our grammar and spelling. Number five, you don't have to, or you should split your letter into paragraphs.
We should.
Now guys, from the letters we have learned from Robert's class, in the case of Jose, this is your first input on letters. How many paragraphs do you need to add? We need between 3 and 4. In most instances, we need 4. We need 4 paragraphs. Let me just erase this part over here. So our salutation is here. What do we put in our first paragraph? As our introduction. What do we do when we introduce our introduction? There are actually 2 things you write in your introduction. One of that is that. One of which is the purpose. Correct. What do we do before that?
Introduce yourself.
We introduce ourselves. Self-introduction. Or if these were guys, an informal letter, we use an informal greeting. For example, if you are writing to your friend, like, say I'm writing to August, dear August, I hope this letter finds you well. That's an example of an informal greeting. And then my next line, the same paragraph, I would write something like, I am writing because I have a favor to ask from you. So that's now our paragraph 1. Okay? Now paragraph 2 should be what? The reason? Normally, guys, I say in letters, we deal with problems. We deal with issues. Therefore, what we do in paragraph 2, guys, is discuss what's the issue all about. So, for example, I'm writing to Lumiere, to August, I mean, and asking for some favor. It is a paragraph 2 now where I lay down. Ano palang issue ko? So for example, the letter is supposed to ask help from your friend because you are traveling to their country. Hindi mo alam what to do. Okay. So I'm going to write here, for example, as you know, August, I'm traveling to your country in 2 weeks' time. And since it's my first time to travel to your country, I'd like to know a couple of things. First, what's the kind of weather I'll be encountering when I get there in August? Second, what clothes do I need to bring? Okay, and third, what activities do I expect to happen? Okay, so this is therefore the part where I lay down the situation itself. Now, as regards the third paragraph, what we normally present is what? Is your
course.
Exactly, your course function. In other words, your solution to the problem. It's either to, for example, to recommend. It could also be to request for something, right? So for instance, if I am asking for information from August in my letter, and they write here, therefore, can you please email me back and answer me the following items? Okay. Or if I'm writing to my boss, because my goal is to take a leave of absence for about 2 weeks, my reasons are here. So therefore, in my paragraph 3, I would write something like, therefore, may I ask for a 2 week leave of absence, starting on this day and ending on this particular day. Okay. And what I would want to propose to help settle down everything. So that's paragraph 3. Paragraph 4 is what usually guys. What do we normally put in our paragraph 4? Your closing remarks or your final words?
Yeah.
Your final words. Now, normally, it is in this paragraph where we talk about what we hope is going to happen next. So typically, we begin with words like I hope or I look forward to. Okay. So for example, if I was asking for something, like in my letter to August, I could write, I hope you can respond soon. I look forward to your reply by email. I may want to leave some contact details if necessary. So for example, if I'm writing to the bank manager for the lost credit card, I can leave my contact details for more information. Okay? So that's your final words. And then from there, guys, you now write yours truly, faithfully, and then your name at the bottom. So, to answer therefore, guys, number 5, yes, you should split your work into paragraphs. And guys, when you do though, please ensure that we follow, guys, yung tinatawag na full block paragraphing method. Can I borrow your book? Let me just illustrate that point, how it works. How a block paragraphing method looks like. Take a look at this one. Okay, this is just for the essay part. But the samples we have in your book illustrate the paragraphing that might be able to observe. Okay? The full block. No indentations. Okay? Notice, guys, this is the paragraph 1. Note that when you were writing, you didn't want time to indent the first line. However, in the IELTS, I'd like you guys to align everything towards the left margin and to demarcate the paragraph. Leave a space after each section. So assuming this is your introduction, leave a space after, and then paragraph 2, the problem. Then space again, course of action. Space again, your final words. Space again, yours truly. Space, your name. Okay? At the very beginning, of course, the dear part, space, paragraph 1. It's very important because your letters should look like one. Otherwise, it will look like one long paragraph altogether, and there seems to be no paragraph in as a result. Okay, so please observe a particular structure. Okay? Now, how about number 6? You can or shouldn't end a formal letter with yours faithfully. What's the answer here? Can we or should we not? Okay. We actually can, right? There are two possibilities. Either you write yours faithfully or what's the other possibility?
Yours
truly. Yes. There's one more over here. Yours truly is also one case. Alright, number seven. A good or inappropriate way to end a formal letter is with I look forward to hearing from you in the near future. Is that a good or inappropriate way? That is a good way to end a formal letter. Guys, if this were informal, how would you do it? How would that do it, guys?
I look forward to hearing from you in the future.
This is very formal. If I'm writing to August, as a friendly letter, how can I make this more informal? See you soon or hear from you soon. Note, in the near future becomes soon. Look forward to hearing from you. It comes just hear from you. So this is therefore informal. And the other one is more formal. Okay? Or yes, see you soon. Sometimes guys, the exclamation mark. Okay? But take note in informal letters, guys, like here, don't use these marks over here. Yes.
Is it okay? Question mark.
Informal? Yes, of course. Especially if your goal is to ask something. Like, may I ask? Or may I know? Yeah. Question, yeah. So formal, yes, it's also possible. Because in formal letters, there's a way for you to formally ask something. Like, may I request for the following documents? That case is a question mark. Also, okay? Yes. There is no hard and fast rule about how many paragraphs you should have. Okay? I always recommend a 4-paragraph outline. Okay? You will find that there may be occasions when these can be merged. What a problem is. So long as there's a logical order of things. Meaning to say, walang magiging problema in terms of the meaning of the letter. So long as you're able to cover all the tasks, no problem. Okay? I'm just showing them the basic format because this can work for both formal and informal. Okay? Hindi din mali yung tatlong paragraphs na. So tama din yung tinuro ko Sir Robert. But this particular outline, this can work. This can work. Okay? Sige. Great? Are we good? Paul? Okay, lang tapos. Sige, ha? We give ourselves a short break. And then after our break, guys, let's discuss the letter below. And then I might have to write something. And let's address the air conditioner. It's getting warm behind the line. Something with our air conditioner. So 10-minute break na tayo, guys. It's now 10:35. Let's resume at 10:45. Okay?